Hello everyone. This was a really fun and interesting experiment. Well, it was more like a project than an experiment, but it was still fun to watch. We got this caterpillar to butterfly kit as a fun way to grow our own butterflies and then free them into the garden to help pollinate the plants. This kit is from naturegifts.com and you can reorder more caterpillars whenever you want. Well, that's not really true. They won't ship them if the weather is under 40 degrees Fahrenheit. So we had to wait until mid-May before it was safe for them to ship it to us. The caterpillars came in a closed, see-through container. I counted 5 caterpillars, 4 larger-sized and 1 smaller one. I almost didn't see it. The lid has tiny holes punched in it for air, and at the bottom is food for them. So you don't take the caterpillars out and feed them. You leave them in the container and watch them eat and grow bigger and bigger every day. The kit also came with a small container to put sugar water in it for the butterflies to drink once they emerge. And it also came with a pop-up habitat. I left that unpopped for now. The kit also came with a pamphlet explaining the life cycle process and what to expect, as well as a coloring sheet for kids to enjoy. And there was a dropper to feed the butterflies, as well as a little spray bottle to mist them. I put these all away for now since we don't have any butterflies just yet. All right, it's the next day and the caterpillars haven't done much of anything yet. Take a look at their size now because in the next couple of days these caterpillars are going to get really fat. Even the littlest guy in the front. I guess that was the runt of this litter. Here's a time lapse of the caterpillars on their second day. Now it's day 3 and you can see a difference in the size of these caterpillars already in just 3 days. Here's another time lapse. This is still day 3. And now it's day 4 and yes, they are getting fatter. Now it's day 7 and you can see the caterpillars are getting fatter and fatter and making quite a mess inside the container. If you look closely, you can see strands of silk they are spinning. And also there are little black balls at the bottom of the cup. That's their poop and you can just leave it there. This is a time lapse for day 7. Here's a better look. You can see the silk they're spinning. If you just look at the caterpillars, they don't seem to move much. That's why the time lapse is interesting to me. You can see them moving over several hours in just a couple of seconds. Now it's still day 7, but it's in the evening and these caterpillars are getting fatter and fatter by the minute. There's a cotton disc under the lid of this cup, and when the caterpillars are ready, they somehow know to climb up to the lid and attach themselves to the disc with strands of silk. Here is the next day, day 8, and there are 2 caterpillars that have decided to migrate to the lid, and they look like they're there to stay. But if you watch the time lapse, you can see that they do go down to get some food, but mainly stay under the lid. And now there seems to be 3 that are hanging out under the lid. Then eventually there were 4, with the 5th caterpillar, the runt of the litter, still rummaging in the food pile at the bottom of the cup. The caterpillars will eventually stop moving and hang upside down in a J shape. And once they're in their J shape, their body will start to change into a chrysalis. In this time lapse, you can see the caterpillars starting to go into the J shape, hanging upside down. It's still day 8, that's 8 days since we received this package, and 4 of the caterpillars are well on their way to changing, but down at the bottom of the cup where the food is the runt. Still not ready yet. 2 of the 4 caterpillars under the lid look like they've already changed into chrysalises. 2 still look more like caterpillars, but they'll change soon enough. Every once in a while, you'll see the chrysalises shaking. This is a natural instinct to ward off predators. It must have sensed some vibrations or something to make it do that. Over the next day, the other 2 caterpillars changed themselves into chrysalises so that eventually 4 were hanging there. But the 5th caterpillar just wasn't ready yet. Now it's day 10 and the 5th caterpillar has finally made its way to the lid of the cup. And the other 4 caterpillars have all changed into chrysalises. I'm just waiting for this last one to change before moving them all to the pop-up habitat. Now it's day 11 and the 5th caterpillar has changed into a chrysalis. So now we have all five hanging upside down from the lid. 24 hours after the last caterpillar has changed into chrysalis is the best time to move them into the habitat, so I'll have to wait until tomorrow. Okay, it's tomorrow, day 12, and it's time to move the chrysalises into their habitat. This is the habitat. It's packed flat, but once you undo the top straps, it pops open. Now it's time to take the lid off the cup, gently, and then peel off the cloth disc, also gently. The kit came with this red plastic safety pin to fasten the disc to the side of the habitat's netting, and so that's what I did, gently. Here you can see the chrysalises still hanging from the discs, but now safely in the habitat. It takes between 7 and 10 days from when the caterpillars change into chrysalises to emerge as butterflies. If you watch them over the next week, you'll see the chrysalises turning darker just before the butterfly is ready to come out. Here's what's left in the cup. The caterpillars had plenty to eat and they poop plenty. Now it's day 21, 3 weeks since these came as caterpillars, and we have butterflies. 4 emerged when I wasn't looking. You can see some red liquid around the habitat. That's called meconium, and it's the waste product that's left over from the butterfly's metamorphosis. I put a piece of watermelon at the bottom of the butterflies to feed on, and I also filled a small container with 1/4 cup of water and 1 of the packets of sugar the kit came with. There's a cotton ball in the middle of the lid that wicks up the sugar water, and the butterflies quickly figured out how to drink from it. The next day, I replaced the watermelon with some cantaloupe, and they really seem to like that better. These are called painted lady butterflies, and they're really very pretty. Looks like they're really enjoying that cantaloupe. I put a leaf in the habitat and put some sugar water on it, but they didn't seem interested in the leaf. The cantaloupe was a big hit. I also put a camera inside the habitat, and you can see one butterfly chasing the other. I'm pretty sure it was a male chasing a female, and I'm pretty sure I saw some hanky-panky going on. I believe the proper term is mating. This might be a great opportunity to explain to kids about the birds and the bees and the butterflies. Now, you're probably wondering if I caught the 5th butterfly emerging. So, I set the camera up inside the habitat, aimed at the last chrysalis hanging on, and I put the time lapse on the camera on a 30-second interval, and wouldn't you know it, the butterfly emerged during that 30-second interval. The chrysalises get darker and darker as it comes closer to the time the butterfly will emerge, so I did this for a whole day and the butterfly still didn't emerge. The next day, I set the camera up again, but I still couldn't get the timing right. You can see here the footage. Unfortunately, well, really fortunately for the young couple, we had a wedding to go to that evening. And so I set the camera up and left. And of course, the last butterfly emerged while we were out, of course. Once the butterfly emerges, it works on stretching its wings. In the chrysalis, the wings are soft and folded in. But now that the butterfly has emerged, it stretches out those wings and forces blood into the veins to strengthen and harden the wings. This process takes 1 or 2 hours, and then the wings are full-sized and hardened. The butterfly stayed in the habitat for another 4 days, enjoying the cantaloupe and the sugar water, and then I felt it was time to release them into the garden. Butterflies have a lifespan of from 2 to 4 weeks, so they really needed to get out, live a bit, mate, although I think they already mated, and then lay eggs that will turn into caterpillars and continue the life cycle. These painted ladies are native to North America, so they should be fine here. And since I released 5 beauties into my garden, I'm hoping they'll continue breeding and producing more butterflies. They really are beautiful and interesting creatures. I hope you enjoyed watching the life cycle of these magnificent creatures as much as I did. It really is incredible to watch them change into beautiful butterflies. And I hope you enjoyed this video. Please hit the subscribe button to help my channel keep growing. I really appreciate it. And thank you for watching. Bye.